So we know that Miranda Barbour, she is charged with one murder. Now she's suddenly opening up and talking. She says this was time to get it all out. She is 19 years young. She's obviously making national news, sir, but you're not buying her story. Tell me why.
Well, anything is possible, Brooke, and of course it's conceivable that she's a serial killer, but I'll tell you why I doubt it. First of all, this would be a very rare case. Now, it's true that about 25% of all serial killers will kill in a team with a partner. And there have been husbands and wives who've killed serially. But, you know, when women kill, and there aren't many who become serial killers, they tend to use poison, they tend to suffocate patients in a hospital with a pillow. They don't usually stab their victims, and they're not 19 years old. Most serial killers are experienced. They get away with murder, otherwise they'd be caught right away, and they're in their 30s and 40s. I think the biggest reason why I'm skeptical is the disorganized way that they killed this particular victim, leaving his body in an alley where it was quickly discovered. You know, if you're a prolific serial killer, you're going to go out of your way to dump the body in a desolate area off a highway so that people don't find the evidence.
Here is how she said she did it. Let me just quote this local paper. I would lure these people in. I studied them. I learned them and even became their friend. I did this to people who did bad things and didn't deserve to be here anymore. Does that sound like if it happened, you know, I know you write about the whole notion of playing God, feeling powerful, right? That plays into that, correct?
Well, you know, false confessors look a lot like serial killers because they share the same motivation. They want to feel powerful and in charge and like big shots. And so they want us to believe that they've killed lots of people. If they kill one, it'll be a big local story. If they kill 22, then they're on CNN.
And why does she want that?
It's national news.
Why would she want that, you think?
Because, you know, these killers and false confessors have a profound sense of powerlessness. They want to feel important. They want to feel special. And they achieve it through a sense of infamy by becoming celebrities.
She said she was molested at age 4. Her mother corroborated that. She says she joined the satanic cult and witnessed a murder, was I think part of a murder at age 13. Might that, sir, have played a part in her story, be it real or not?
Well, you know, it's possible, and I'm hoping that the police investigators will indeed take this very seriously. But let me tell you that there are millions of people who have suffered as children, millions of them, and most of them never hurt anyone. They grow up to be healthy, decent, civil human beings, and you can't just take a childhood experience and say, that's the reason that she's a serial killer.